Michael from Red Chair Diaries, and one of my follow-up commentaries about our daily febs. This is the final list, right? And the yellow ones are ones that I had seen prior to watching them again in February, and the rest of them, and that's one third of them, it's 9 out of 28. And the rest of them are ones that were new to me, you know, except for reputation. And someone asked me, I don't know if it's Bob the Sub or Blu-ray Fan 66, was wondering, you know, maybe I should do a list of my favorite three of from this experience. And I can't find the exact notes, so, you know, it's attached to a video somewhere. So, apologize if I've got those names wrong with somebody else. I mean no disrespect by that. So, I would say, off the, pardon me, what is it, 20 movies that I had not seen, or 20, or 19, I did 28. I would say the three movies that I liked the best, or surprised me the most that I ended up liking them, something like that, because putting them all together and trying to quantify movie against movie, it doesn't really work. I don't know how people do top 10 lists. So I would say I ended up enjoying Slumdog Millionaire a lot more than I anticipated. So if we're going to use any criteria, I think that criterion may be the best. You know, I ended up enjoying it. And I thought it was extremely well done. So I was very pleased with that movie. Another one that I really enjoyed was Foxy Brown, you know, because it was just a period piece made in 1971, 2, 3, or 4, something like that. And it's of its time, it's of its culture. Remember, that's only 6 or 7 years after the Watts riots and a lot of civil rights riots and things like that, the so-called race riots, you know, and to me they're civil rights riots, but and dignity riots, but not everybody agrees, I suppose. So I really, really enjoyed that. I thought it was great fun. Not a masterpiece of movie making, let's not go over the top, but fresh and interesting even after all that time. I thought it was quite well done. I don't want to oversell it. I think in the review I gave all kinds of conditions, but I personally derived immense pleasure from watching that movie. There's those delayed reactions on printers are quite amusing when they're trying to shut down or something. Thank you, that's enough. Number 19, The Lives of Others would have to be number 3. I knew what it was going to be, but I just thought it was so well done. I liked the story. I don't like the events in the story. I liked the way the story was told. I thought the acting was good. Once again, I forgot that I was reading subtitles. I keep thinking that I was hearing them speaking English. And it's kind of a, you know, it's kind of a sad story, you know. I mean, it's about a, you know, totalitarian regime and East Berlin in the early 70s, I think it was, and not great times, not a lot of fun. Maybe it was the early 80s, it all runs together. As far as, what do you call it, runners-up or honorable mentions, I guess is the expression. Oh, Bad Lieutenant, Port of Call, New Orleans. Fantastic, so I can't even go at 3, I have to go at 4. That was just, is so well done, you know. Werner Herzog, Nicolas Cage together, you know, that two talented but confused egos in some ways, I think. But then again, when I heard, I think I told you, when I heard Werner Herzog on the radio, it's Phillips. He's very, very articulate, I must say. And then as a, well, The Big Lebowski is in another classification all its own. But as an honorable mention, I will say Season of the Witch. I enjoyed it, considering that it makes no sense and it's stupid. But I just enjoyed the whole theatricality and the movie making of it. You know, just a banal story. I enjoyed it. And it's not certainly as bad as some of the critics said, because the shit arises. Supposedly it floats, you know. There's a lot of it out there. And I think that's about it. Disappointing movies of the new groups. Equilibrium, I didn't think it lived up to all the raves on the net by particularly, I think, the younger viewers. I don't think so at all. Office Space, I enjoyed it. I understood where it was coming from. I lived some of those experiences. But it's a little movie. We know that, but I think it's been overrated. And I want to say that one of my experiences with things like offices, the ego, the status, and all of this, when I started working for the government at BCIT, British Columbia Institute of Technology, I got around to reading their policies and procedures book, which was two-inch manuals at least. This is pre-internet. They're all on the internet now, or at least the intranet. And as assistant manager of the college bookstore, that's the job I joined the organization as, because I had been managers of other stores outside in the private sector. I was allowed to have a chair with arms, but the secretaries or clerks, whatever they were called in those days, now they're called associates or customer service or whatever, but they were called clerks, clerk two or something. They couldn't have a chair with an arm. And as assistant manager, I think I was allowed a filing cabinet, but not a credenza. A credenza belonged to a manager. So, you know, these things do actually happen. And not 8 years ago, when I became a full director as opposed to like an associate director, I was supposed to have a certain number of square feet in space, and there was no place to put me besides a former manager's office, and I used to joke about it all the time. My office is too small. There's no room for, you know, I didn't have room for all these extra things that I was supposed to be able to have. But I said, no, this office is just fine, you know, and I would say it because I found it amusing. I did not dislike my office, but to be honest, it was a bit crowded. But anyway, I had a window and I had a free parking spot right outside the door. So that's worth a lot. So I think that's about it. Oh, Vantage Point was another one that just I thought was terribly, terribly disappointing, considering the money put in it. Didn't care for that one too much. And I think that's about it. I'm not going to start talking about the ones that I've seen many times. Anyway, Michael from Red Chair Diaries, and we'll be doing it again some other time, but maybe only 5 movies for a month. That's another point for another video I'm just going to do in a few minutes. See you around the 2.